Welcome to the interesting session of affordance in UX design. Now in this slide, you see a window which has some view. You can only see the view which the window is showing you. So in this case, the object is the window which can afford or show you that fine view of the city. So what is affordance? Affordance is what the environment offers the individual, which helps the users to do something. In terms of UX designing, affordance are the characteristics of the user interface objects or features which helps the user to perform the task. Here are some examples of affordance. When we see signal, we know that red means stop, yellow means ready to go, and green means go. Similarly, when we see handle, we know that we have to catch and pull. When we sense phone vibration, we know that some kind of message has come. It could be mail, WhatsApp message, etc. When we want to open some app on the screen, we see either the app logo or name and then click on it for some kind of action to be performed. So these were the examples of affordance we see in our day-to-day life. So affordance plays an important role in UX design to give the best experience to the user. So, to afford means to help, to offer, or provide something to the user. In designing, affordance is a discrete unit of meaning, including words, images, gestures, textures, sound, etc. I hope the meaning of affordance is clear to you all. Let us see the different types of affordance in interaction design. There are 5 types of affordance in interaction design. Namely, cognitive, physical, sensory, functional, and emotional. Let us see one by one. The first affordance which we are going to see is cognitive affordance. As the name goes cognitive, it means the process of thinking. So cognitive affordance means to help users with the cognitive actions such as thinking, deciding, remembering, etc. This affordance is used for less experienced users or novice users for a reason that they might find it difficult to take decisions or remember something. They are people who need help with understanding and learning. For example, putting a tool tip or balloon tip for showing the meaning of an icon in an application so users know whether they should click it or not. Another example would be using a symbol of an icon that clearly conveys its message and the user knows the consequence of clicking on it. As we can see in the diagram, the phone symbol is clear that it can be used to dial a number or to see contacts. The second type of affordance is physical affordance, which means to help users with their physical actions such as where to click, where to point, how to drag and move things, etc. If I say it in terms of non-computer aspects, it could be about how to use handle doors, levers, or how to move things around, etc. Like for some door handles, we need to push, while for others, we need to turn the knob to open it, etc. One more example, as you can see in the image of how and where to place the button in an app. If the user gets proper sequence of clicking the button, then it's easier for the user to use it. Or else the user has to go through ups and downs of the screen to finish the task. For example, physical affordance features for an interface button design, where adequate size and easy to access location of the button should be there, along with ease of click. Physical affordance is used for experienced users, where there is less need to elaborate cognitive affordance. The third kind of affordance is sensory affordance, which helps users with their sensory actions, such as seeing, hearing, feeling, etc. It plays a crucial role for supporting cognitive and physical affordance. For example, if I need to create a button text, I need to consider proper font size of the text and the background color as well, so that font size, color and the style combination can help in seeing the action of the user as it should be pleasing to the eye. The fourth affordance is functional affordance, where it helps users to do things and to do it in right way. In simple terms, it could be defined as performing some actions such as clicking to invoke the internal or back-end functionality. It adds meaning or purpose to physical affordance. As in physical affordance, we click. For example, so functional affordance would help to get the result of clicking and give it to the user. So functional affordance links usability to usefulness. Let us consider an example of sort button in Excel. When we look at the button, we think that it will sort and give me. So it becomes cognitive affordance. When we click on it, it becomes physical affordance. On clicking, it does sorting internally and gives us the result. So it becomes functional affordance. When we see the sorted result in front of us on the screen, it becomes sensory affordance. So we have seen the use of some affordance in one example itself. Let us see the last affordance, which we all are familiar with, that is emotional affordance. In this affordance, it helps users to get quality emotional impact, such as joy, happy, satisfaction, etc. The features or design aspects connects emotional connect with the user. Like the ambience we see in the mall, which makes us excited and gives us joy, specifically if there is an event or festival. This is the summary of affordances, where emotional affordance is considered in all the kinds of affordance. Kindly go through it. Thank you.